Good afternoon from Broadwoods. It's the final day of the SWPL 1 season and things are hanging in the balance. Very much weighted in Celtic's favour. We are here for Rangers against Partick Thistle. Essentially, Rangers have to either overcome an absolutely insane goal difference of 16 or hope that Celtic do not win and they do take care of matters here in Cumbernauld. It's something that hasn't been a foregone conclusion this season. Yes, they have seen Partick Thistle off a couple of times, but there's also been a 0-0 draw in there as well. Celtic at home to Hibs at Celtic Park as well, the big surface. I'm sure they'll be confident and expectant of keeping their end of the bargain. If they don't, Rangers have to be ready to pounce. I'm your commentator, Andy Barge. With me is Claire Gemmell. It's not quite the same jeopardy as this time last year, Claire. Final day of the season drama, though, nonetheless.
It's still drama, as you say. Certainly not like last season. But, you know, Rangers still have a job to do at the end of the day. I think all they can do is concentrate themselves at the minute. Just as you say, Andy, it is greatly weighted in Celtic's favour. And I think they'll know that. But they still need to go out and get the 3 points first.
We're just having a look across as it's, I think, probably reflected in the crowd here at Broadwood today that there's a chance Rangers could win the league. And well, the stand is half full on one side and empty on the other. I think that probably illustrates the approach that, or the realistic approach that people are taking to this final day. But we've seen it before, even in the men's game as well, when things don't always go as planned on final day. And if Celtic do, on the rare occasion, not pick up the 3 points that they're expected to do this term, Rangers have to be ready to take advantage. We'll have a look at the teams then, with them coming out of the tunnel any second for Rangers. An important 3-2 win against Hibs midweek. Kirsty Howitt with a hat-trick. She's up top again with Rio Hardy. Between them, they have 39 goals this season. Kirsty McLean is fit enough to start after returning from the bench during the week. She missed a couple of months with a knee injury. And PFA Player of the Year Rachel Rowe not involved today. She's still injured, as is Rachel McLaughlin. For Partick Thistle, change of shape today for them. Maybe a surprise to see Carla Boyce and Rachel Donaldson left out. Cara Henderson is put further up the park. Rosie Slater comes into defence to make it a five across the back. And there are rare starts as well for Cowan and McQuillan. And they've had their fair share of meetings this season, even in the cup final. Some might argue this is more important for Rangers as they look for their second SWPL 1 title. Thistle looking to be the thorns in their side, with Celtic galloping to success if they can see off Hibs. Will Rangers fly out the traps and force Celtic's hand? If we get anywhere near the drama that we got last season, we're in for a bit of a wild ride. I think that lack of jeopardy is apparent with the three usual title chasing teams not playing each other. If two of them were up against each other today, there would certainly be a whole different aspect to this.
I certainly think if it was a Celtic Rangers final day, it would be fantastic. I think that's absolutely what everybody would want, but we find ourselves where we are, and as I said, Celtic certainly favourites. They've been flying the last few weeks, so I expect them to go out there and win this game, if I'm honest.
Well, there's still matters to be taken care of for Rangers, no matter what happens at Celtic Park. It doesn't just suddenly become meaningless. But if it does get to half-time, the hour, approaching 70 and it's not going Celtic's way, pulses will start to quicken here.
But that's exactly what Rangers are hoping for, that Hibs can keep Celtic out, keep them at bay, which is going to be a very hard job. But they need to believe that can happen. So they need to start well, they need to get goals in and just take care of their own job. It's all they can do. It's actually not a nice feeling when you don't have any control over what's going to happen. You're looking for a favour from somebody else.
Well, what can Rangers do for starters? I'm sure that managers and players all say just focusing on ourselves, there's nothing really we can do, but they must be kept up to date with what's happening at the other stadiums. If Rangers race into a two-goal lead here within the first little while, I'm pretty sure the Celtic players will quickly hear about it.
I mean, certainly from playing myself, I would want to know. You want to know what the job is ahead of you. How are you meant to do it if you don't know, for instance, that Celtic are getting beat 1-0? So definitely, I think they'll be told.
Well, they're heading early on here, and Eva Easden catches just before it crosses our line. Comfortable hands for the young goalkeeper. Potentially our last match for Thistle here on loan from Glasgow City. A bright future ahead for her. It's actually a bit of a surprise she's looking so comfortable out there. I think she was a bit risky ahead of this one with a thigh injury, but with Megan Cunningham on loan from Rangers, there was no option really. And she has to be off the mark here. And just safe hands on this occasion.
I think she's been fantastic for Thistle this year. I think she's, when asked to, she's stepped up, she's performed well. You know, she's still a really young goalkeeper, but you can see all the talent and potential she's got. So I think she's been great for them to get this season on loan.
Slater slightly misjudges, and Hardy can smell blood. Good to see Kirsty McLean back playing again. I think not just if you're from a Rangers persuasion, but for the national team as well. It was, I think, a good few months she was missing for there. Not back in the Scotland squad yet.
Well, I'm sure she will be, though, and I think it's great to see her back in the pitch, straight back into this game. I just think she gives Rangers something different in the midfield that Cornet and McLaughlin don't provide. You know, I think her in there, along with if Rachel Rowe was fit, would be quite a frightening thing to watch, actually. But, yeah, it's great to see her back in that pitch.
So she's just playing a little bit further forward than Chelsea Cornet and Olivia McLaughlin again, who would be her second last game for Rangers, depending on if she plays in the cup final next week. Up on loan from Aston Villa. She opts to go to Doherty via Catherine Hill. Rangers split form, 6 wins from 9 so far. They lost against Celtic and a surprising defeat to Hearts. Draw against Celtic as well. It's been difficult for Partick Thistle again. Just the one win for them in the split. They beat Hibs 3-2. Double from Carla Boyce making the difference. She's on the bench today. But apart from that, losses all the way for Partick Thistle in the splits. It's a step up compared to the regular season. As McLaughlin dances away from one marker. Taylor trying to drive away, but it makes its way to Howitt. Hill in uncharted territory, but Partick Thistle break clear. Hey, outfought by Doherty, who fizzes one in. And David Easden gets there ahead of Kirsty Howitt.
I think Partick Thistle are doing well to crowd out the box, but Rangers are trying to pass through it when it's almost impossible to pass through that. You know, you need to find other ways. Get the ball wide earlier, I think, and obviously a better cross in at the box. I mean, you can't cross it into the goalkeeper's hands. You're never going to score that way.
The disparity between Celtic and Rangers goal difference-wise is quite extreme. It's 16. So don't think we're going to see an 8-0 win and an 8-0 loss today. I think it's purely on the basis that Celtic failed to
beat Hibs that this is going to be settled. And if, for example, the goal difference was closer, Thistle have stifled Rangers on a few occasions this season. As McCauley breezes into the box. Rio Hardy not on her best form recently and unable to send Rangers into an early lead.
No, it was unlucky there. It was a great ball into the box and it should be going into the back of the net, really. You know, you're not getting in. She's walking straight onto it and she can't find the back of the net. And I think that's the problem that Rangers have had over the last few weeks, is that all their strikers are not really on great form at the minute. So, whether Celtic, on the other hand, are. But just to address your last point, no, definitely we're not going to see an 8-0 win and the other side 8-0 loss for Celtic. So, yeah, they definitely need a favour off of Hibs.
Now, there has been a 0-0 this season between Thistle and Rangers as well. Just at the end of April, they were at 1-1 until the 85th minute. Late Rangers double sealed the victory, an important one on that occasion. Sarah Ewan's coming off the bench to put Rangers in the lead with five to go.
I think that's the thing with Partick Thistle. It's not in many games that they lose multiple goals. You know, there has been games where they've lost a number of goals, but it's not something that's common for them. And just as you're speaking about how close the games have been between them, so I think Rangers themselves will know that they're not going out here today to score a barrel load of goals against them.
Thistle's only battering in the split has come from Celtic. 5-0 at the start of that phase of the league season. Apart from that, the games that they have lost have been by one or two goal margins, really. McCauley looking dangerous from the start here. Slater's an obstacle this time. In steps McQuillan. And it's completed by Lawton, PFA Team of the Year member. That right back of the five for Thistle today. First involvement for Essen, who has taken the gloves from Jenna Fife in the last 4 to 6 weeks after that defeat to Hearts in the first half of the split. Essen was given the chance and she's kept her place. McCauley. McLean. No qualms for Easden.
It's good feet there from her, and she's obviously backs herself to take the strike. It's going to need to be some strike from there to beat Easton right enough, but it's trying something else, isn't it? And she's unlucky.
Rangers Players Player of the Year this season, Kirsty McLean. And you've missed a few months with injury and still picking up that award. It speaks to the impact you've had before it.
You've just took the words out of my mouth, actually. I think that just shows the impact she's had on the team, the fact that she's pretty much been out about 4 months and she's still picking up that award.
I would expect her to see her back in the Scotland squad in the very near future. I think the fact that she's starting this game could even raise a few eyebrows for the games coming up for Scotland, that she's not in there.
Yeah, but maybe just fearing that she's not got the match fitness to be included in the squad, and maybe that's his thinking behind it. You know, we'll never know, or maybe, given this is only her first minutes, how that she's going to react to that as well. But I think she'll definitely be back in.
First half foray forward for Thistle. Sinclair struggles to feed Henderson. Couple of starters for Rangers today in the upcoming Scotland squads. Chelsea Cornet in midfield is in there. Kirsty Howitt as well. Nicola Doherty, the third one. And here she is, looking to clip one down the line for her international colleague. Medag with a task in her hands to keep this in play. And breathe. Cornet. Just perfectly weighted for Lizzie Arnott to couldn't quite bring it down.
It's a fantastic switch of play. Is that to the ball you would want, and Lizzie Arnott would want, but she just doesn't control it well enough.
McLean. For her size, so good at protecting the ball. Always aware.
She is, but then just as you said that, she lost the ball. But no, she is. She's
good. Nobody saw that.
She is very good with her body, you know, as you said, for her kind of smaller stature. She uses it very well.
From Howitt down the line, Arnott just gets there. She's looking for McLean on the cutback. Taylor Brave in the tackle.
It still feels, I don't know if you feel this way, Andy, or not, but I still feel as if Rangers are a bit flat. You know, you wouldn't know that they need to win the game right now, I don't think. I think it's just...
Well, they're in here. It's Howitt. Wonderful effort. And he's been unable to keep it out. And Rangers beginning to keep their end of the bargain. Howitt with the early strike. And that certainly forces Celtic's hand across the city.
It's a great ball over the top and basically telling me to be quiet and what I was talking about. But, you know, that's that. Just direct in behind, a bit more urgency. That's exactly where it comes from, Kirsty Howitt playing the shoulder, and she just knows where the goal is, and it's a great finish into the corner and gives Easton no chance.
Hat-trick hero Wednesday night against Hibs, and getting Rangers off the mark here. Celtic still 0-0. So as it stands, Rangers are champions. Look, twisting inadvertently, getting it to Faulkner. McLaughlin grappling with Cody Hay, sister of Rangers winger Brogan, who is on the bench today. McCauley with so much space again. Cowan shows interest. McCauley across.
I think she can get that ball earlier there. You know, I don't see the need to pass the Chelsea corner to then go out to Mia McCauley. Just give it straight away. Let her go 1v1. She's just proven there how dangerous she is when she can get at defenders.
And here is Cornet again. McLean scanning for McLaughlin. Here's Arnott. McCauley's header. No issue for Ava Easton.
It's good feet by Lizzie Arnott to get the space for herself, get the cross into the box, but it's going behind Mia McCauley, so it's impossible for her to get any power on the header.
Partick Thistle manager Brian Graham, the Championship Player of the Year in the men's divisions, and maybe a bit aggrieved not to be the SWPL 1 Manager of the Year, I would suggest.
I think nobody could argue that if he had have won it, then it's something they would have deserved. I think he's done a fantastic job with Partick Thistle, comfortably in the top 6 this year, got to a cup final, so he's done an amazing job with the what he's got at his disposal.
9 more points this season than they earned last year, and getting a win in the split as well, which they weren't able to do last term. Just 1 draw against Hearts last season after the league splits. 3-2 win against Hibs in their favour this term. Arnott trying to keep the attack going for Rangers, gives it to McLaughlin, and she was caught slightly late, and that means Rangers free kick.
It's just what Partick Thistle's game's about. It's about being physical and being aggressive. They're very good at it, they're very organised. It's just a bit much there, you know, come right in behind. It's always going to be a free kick.
Only Doherty back for Rangers here as they go hunting for a second. Hill, the flag's up. And that really would have been quick fire. It's Cathy Hill looking to get involved in what Rangers hope is a memorable day.
It's some ball in, and it's a great run by Catherine Hill. She'll be gutted that that doesn't count, because it is some finish, but it's difficult to see from here whether it actually was offside, but it must have been tight.
Arnott. One-way traffic at Broadwood. And what is a breezy day, Claire? No sunshine splitting the skies as we had yesterday. Pretty chilly up here at the back of the stand. Billick only can make its way to Chelsea Cornets. Every loose ball falling at the feet of a blue jersey. Nicoli, starting position slightly further back this time. Cornet has to scamper. Drops the shoulder to get away from Hay. It's opened up here for Cornet. It's just wave after wave, and Ava Easton is able to watch that comfortably float wide.
You can't blame Chelsea Cornet for shooting there, because you see some of the goals she scored over the last few weeks, some crackers. So she comes in, and it's something that I know that Joe Potter is wanting more from her, is more shots, more goals. So she's obviously taking that on board, come inside, and she's unlucky to hit it wide.
She started the season in brilliant goal-scoring form, Chelsea Cornet. It's tailed off. She's got seven this term. Important one in the Scottish Cup semi against Celtic, but in the league she hasn't really been able to keep it up since the first couple of months. Remember one she scored here against Glasgow City, I think it was, screamer into the top corner from about 20 yards.
She doesn't tend to score tap-ins, does she? It's always screamers, as you say.
Udag angling for Arnott, who'll keep it in, but has fallen foul of the offside line.
I think that will frustrate Joe Potter, because, and I know as a player it used to frustrate me when the furthest away player looking at along the line finds herself offside, because there's no reason to be. You can see where the line is, so make sure you're keeping yourself on, because they're in a good position there, and they'll get Partick Thistle pinned back.
McLean. Mia McCauley with loads of room on the right hand side again. It doesn't fall her way this time. Shona Cowan loses out. You can see the left strapping on her knee. She's just back from injury there, as McCauley cuts it back for McLean. Rangers lacking the cutting edge in the final third so far.
They're getting into really good areas, but as you said, it's a final pass. They're just choosing the wrong pass more often than not. There, Mia McCauley looked as if she wasn't sure what she wanted to do with it, and then ends up trying to find McLean, who is not in a position to shoot from there.
Off Catherine Hills Fitz. Like a cannonball, and Nicola Doherty unable to bring under control. Snicker Doherty has said that this is really what Scottish football needs and what the stakeholders want in it. Not sure if it's exactly what Rangers want, with it being completely in Celtic's hands at the moment, but Doherty saying that they're delighted to be part of it all as McCauley curls one in, and that's almost a second for Howitt. And that's really, in a nutshell, Mia McCauley's game there on the right-hand side. Just constant danger.
It's great play. Just taps it past and runs onto it. And it's a great delivery into the box this time, right in behind the defence. It's so difficult to mark. And Kirsty Howitt, for me, has to score.
Can they make the most of the corner there? Taking the scenic route anyway. Love the reverse for Kirsty Howitt and McLean. The tackle from Emma Lawton. How much yardage can she gain here? She's all on her own. McQuillan trying to catch up. Nicola Doherty in her way. And thus ends the Partick Thistle counter.
And I think that's what she gives you. She's got great pace, Lawton. You've seen it there. And I think Rangers need to be wary of that. Yes, they need goals, but unlikely going to score the amount that they need, so they need to take care at the back too and not leave space like that. Nicola Doherty does do well, but there seems to be a wee clash of heads. I think they've run into each other.
Yeah, she's had a brilliant season, Emma Lawton. There's interest in her. Brian Graham desperate to keep her, and I don't think she's against that idea.
I can understand why he wants to keep her. Again, just there, she's shown how much she gives to the squad. She's carried the ball from her own half right up almost to the Rangers box, and it's invaluable, particularly when you're pushed so back in games the way Partick Thistle are in this one.
We'll keep you up to date as best we can as well on what's happening at Celtic Park. It's still 0-0 there. So Rangers top of the league as it stands. Remember, they need to better Celtic's result this afternoon. Interesting to see if Rangers try to bring Olivia McLaughlin and or Libby Bance back here next season. Bance did sign a new contract at Brighton, as did McLaughlin at Villa. So I'm not sure their parent clubs will be in a hurry to let them go.
I think probably it would be more likely that they'd come back on another loan, you know, if they're obviously, as you said, attached to their parent clubs, and if they just sign new contracts. But I think certainly McLaughlin has been excellent since she's come in. I think she's done a great job in there.
Well, McCauley's broken the trap here, and another one goes begging for Rangers. They're starting to rack these up.
And I think exactly that, and then the chance before with Kirsty Howitt, you know, it's great play here, great turn by Kirsty Howitt, and finds McCauley wide. She's got acres out of room. She only needs to hit the target there. Just put it into the corner. She lashes at it over the bar. And Joe Potter said after the Hibs game that she felt as if they created a lot of chances, but were basically squandering them.
Rangers have scored four in a league game once since mid-January, ironically against Glasgow City, one of the teams probably wouldn't expect that to come against. The split naturally affects that, but at the start of the season they were sticking 5, 6, 7 goals past teams, but Celtic have done it on a far more regular basis, hence the disparity in the goal difference.
That's exactly it. Celtic have just been on fire in front of goal and getting the goals when they need them, and taking care of teams where there's, I feel as if Rangers have been stumbling through some games, just getting by at 1-0.
Rangers treble hunting as well, remember. Beat Partick Thistle in the League Cup final in the springtime. And the Scottish Cup final against Hearts next week. And they still, well, as it stands, we can't really diminish it too much, although Celtic are expected to win. As it stands, they're going to win SWPL 1 unless Celtic can go and score a goal. Granted, they have three quarters of the game left to do that. Lawton up against Arnott, and that is a Thistle corner, their first foray into opposition territory.
And I think this is where they need to concentrate. Everybody needs to know what their job is. You need to mark properly, because Thistle are dangerous in there. They're dangerous from corners. So I think this is going to be a really good opportunity for Partick Thistle here to try and equalise.
Everyone in pink and grey marked in the Rangers area. Is it stumped back in by Bullock? Cowan asking a lot of Sinclair. Midag. McCauley again trying to isolate Cowan. He sticks to our task well on this occasion.
You can hear the players shouting on the pitch to Mia McCauley, 1v1. Obviously realise how good she is at it. Giving her the ball there, it's defended well, and obviously chooses to go back to Midag, but I do think they need to use her more.
Are you surprised she's not in the A squad yet, Scotland?
Yeah, I am actually, and you know, I know she's still young, but I think she's proven this season how capable she is, and I think absolutely she's ready for that next step up.
McCauley looking to send Howitt away, and if she's got the pace here to beat Slater, Rangers are in. Slater recovers well, and she stops Howitt in her tracks, and with McCauley on hand as well, that's an important intervention by Rosie Slater.
No, that's fantastic defending by Rosie Slater. You think Howitt's away from her, but she recovers so well, holds her up, and then she's got her back to goal. But it's a good tackle there, but I don't know if it's her shoulder she's landed on. She looks to be in a bit of pain.
Yeah, well, she's contributed already, Kirsty Howitt. She and Joe Potter will hope it's not the last.
And you can just see it there, the way she falls and can't get the arm down to stop. That'd be a sore one.
One goal from 20 now this season for Kirsty Howitt. And Rangers find a second here as Midag strikes! Yes, they can! And this is Rangers really sending out a message. They were always likely to take care of Thistle today, but they're wasting no time in seizing this game. The next challenge, can they go and seize the title?
It's a great finish, isn't it? It's on her weaker foot, but she's got the time. She can eye it up, and she just puts it into the corner past Easton. But I think Partick Thistle will be disappointed. They win the first header, but Midag standing free with nobody within 5 yards of her. So I think if I was Brian Graham, I'd be saying, if you're winning the first one, you need to think about where the second one's going to fall and get out and put pressure on it. But you cannot take away from the finish. It was fantastic.
Rifled across. Goal from Thistle Midag. Remember her popping up with a few important ones when Rangers won the league in 21-22. And that's a brilliant free kick against Hibs, ironically, to win the game 1-0 towards the end of the season. McQuillan couldn't resist. Maybe a bit of time off for Brian Graham after this game today, I'm sure. Disappointment for him on Friday in the Scottish Premiership playoff semi-final. Losing in penalties to Raith Rovers, and they'll play either Ross County or St Johnstone in the playoff final. As McQuillan tries to scamper away from a couple of blue jerseys, it's picked up again by Cornett.
I think Rangers were lucky there. I think she just can't get it out of her feet to get that pass away, but they found herself. This is what I'm saying. I understand they need goals, but you still need to make sure you're doing the job at the back.
Walton with some proper attention paid to Lizzie Arnott as Henderson tries to bend her run. Midag's path. Collie the intended target as usual, but Cowan had read it this time. McLaughlin there ahead of Bullock. Hardy. I see the surface looks particularly sticky this afternoon.
It does. It's, you just seen it there with Hardy, didn't you? Going under her feet.
Collie's cross. And Hardy ducking out of the way, maybe. Maybe she had a shout from Lizzie Arnott.
I'm not sure. It looked like a duck to me. I don't know if she maybe got a wee hand in the back or a shout, but to me, I don't think Lizzie was close, so...
Sly hand in the back, maybe. This has passed half an hour now. Celtic still 0-0. Rangers doing what they need to do here.
And that's the thing, they can only concentrate on their own job. I'm sure they're trying to get information from the side where they can about what's going on in that other game, because as I said earlier, I certainly would want to know, and I think it'll be filling them with confidence, as you were talking about at the start of the game. You know, can they hold on to 70 minutes that's still 0-0, and then at that point I think they'll maybe start growing in confidence. Is it going to be their day? But we know how good Celtic can be at coming back and winning a game.
An issue here for Partick Thistle. I think that's Cody Hay, who's down injured just off your screen at the moment, as Joe Potter rallies the troops. I think there is somebody just getting ready as well on the Thistle bench, unless it was just a change of jersey. It could be Rachel Donaldson perhaps over on the far side, as Cody Hay slowly makes her way back to her feet, and it looks unlikely that she will face her sister at any point this afternoon. And yes, Rachel Donaldson is stripped and ready to replace the winger. And Rachel Donaldson, who scored what must be Thistle's goal of the season, surely, in the cup final against Rangers, comes on to play for the majority of this one.
It's certainly a goal she won't forget. It was a cracker, and you know, Rangers had probably majority of the ball in that, and they didn't have many opportunities, Partick Thistle, in that game, but certainly when it came her way, she took it.
Lawton does well to escape the press. Cornett. Henderson's tackle more robust than fair. Midag, a member of the Rangers team that went undefeated. Cowan unable to keep that in place. He was given a task to do by McQuillan. Howitt's thought process razor sharp. Here's McCauley in behind again. And it's kept out by Faulkner. Rangers queuing up here. McLean takes over. Patience has to be the name of their game here. McCauley. Inside or out, it's no matter to her. Well stopped this time by Lucy Sinclair.
Mia McCauley's been fantastic today for Rangers. I think she just looks as if she's completely up for it. Every time she gets the ball, she's looking to take her man on, and she's getting, more often than not, getting good deliveries into the box. And we've seen Lizzie Arnott come in at the back post scoring many a time, but it's a great clearance off the line.
She's come up with some important goals this season, Mia McCauley. She missed the target earlier from almost point blank range, but she scored three times against City, once in the derby against Celtic as well. Here she is, looking to put one on a plate for Olivia McLaughlin, who isn't hungry.
And as you say, it's on a plate, isn't it? It's great again, finding her again. She has been the difference for me, for Rangers. She just looks so up for it. It's fantastic in here, you know, it's crowded, but she threads it into her feet. She just needs to hit the target and it's in.
Unlikely that they will truly rue these misses, Rangers, with the unlikelihood of it going to any sort of goal difference settlement, unless Thistle are able to score a couple of goals and take the points that they have away from them.
Well, it is really unlikely. It's not going to happen, let's be honest. It's not going to come down to goals. But I think for them, this is, over the last, I would say, 2 months or so, this has been a common theme with Rangers. Easy chances, or very good chances, and not put them in the box. So I think that's what they will then be thinking about if they don't win this title.
And they have shared the goals around this season as well, Joe Potter's team. Just a quick glance. Howitt on 19 now, Hardy 21. This is league only. McCauley 12, Cornet 7 from midfield. McLean 4 from midfield. She's missed a couple of months with injury. Catherine Hill and Medag scoring from the back as well. So it's not like they're shy of contributors in that sense. It just could be so much more profitable.
Exactly, they do. I think most players in that team, obviously don't know this fact, but I think probably all of them have scored a goal at one point on that pitch. But the problem is, as I said, when they're getting chances, very good chances and very good positions in the pitch, you need to be more clinical. And it's something that Joe Potter has said in many interviews over the last few months.
Can they carve something out here as McLean wrestles it away from McQuillan? Docherty looking in behind for Cornet. It's seen away by Faulkner. But credit to Thistle here as well. You know, they haven't really afforded Rangers too much room in the box. They've had the ball over the top, which Howitt scored from. Mia McCauley's miss. And the opportunity which McLaughlin had a moment ago. But the second goal came from a set piece. Open play, they've been fairly rigid.
I certainly think they're trying their best to keep it in front of them, but the problems are coming when they're getting the likes of Mia McCauley on the ball and they're managing to get it in behind. But if they can keep them in front, I think they're doing well. But certainly in the box, there's only so many of those chances, surely, that you can have before you then lose a goal. So I think they need to try and nullify Mia McCauley.
She's asking for the ball now, which doesn't come her way. Chelsea Cornet opts for the simple one from the dag. McLean dropping deep to dictate. Hardy's on her heels. Docherty direct now. Picked up by Arnott. picked up by Howitz and clearing the way.
I think Hardy struggled to get into the game today. She likes to drop in and try and pick the ball up in between the lines, but just as you were saying, Thistle are very tight and made it really difficult for her. They got on the ball and get into the game.
She's their top league scorer, Rio Hardy, by a couple from Kirsty Howitt, but seven games now without a goal in the league. Scored in the cup semi against Celtic, but in SWPL 1 she hasn't finished the season with a flourish.
No, she's not, and it happens obviously at points through the season for strikers, but again, just as I'd said earlier, I think unfortunately for Rangers it seems to have happened to all the strikers at once.
That's how it is unable to break through. Thistle, she has a little bit of wind in her sails. She's not long back from injury. That hat-trick against Hibs will have helped her.
It definitely will, and as you say, she's just back from injury, so it does take time to get your form back, back to match fitness, and she's obviously got the hat-trick the other day, so yeah, I mean, I'm sure she will. She probably won't be wanting the season to end because she's starting to get back onto form, but it's ultimately just a wee bit too late.
And straight back in the national team set-up as well. McLean turning into trouble. That's well read by Taylor. And the centre half is galloping forward to support Lawton, who gives Doherty a gentle shove in the back. That's enough for the whistle.
It's something Nicola Doherty's very good at. She uses her body well. It's just experience there. She just gets across in front and feels the contact and goes down. You see her do it probably once a game, win a free kick that way. But it's great play and gets her team out of pressure.
Hardy on the turn. Arnett, drop of the shoulder, good cross, flags down, Rangers have three. There's the form, it's Kirsty Howitt, who now has five in her last, well, 1.5 games. What a return from injury for the forwards.
It's a great goal. It's great feet here again by Lizzie Arnett. I say it about her all the time, she's so difficult to mark because she can go both ways. Great ball into the box, and Partick Thistle just don't know where Kirsty Howitt is. She gets a wee bit of fortune, it goes through the legs of Easton, but she needs to be in there. She's in the right area, and you know, she's putting the ball in the net, which some of her teammates are struggling with.
And these goals will echo down the M80 to Celtic Park, where it remains 0-0 between Celtic and Hibs, with half-time not far away. Here's how it again. Wide it goes. I wonder at what point the hope becomes supercharged among the Rangers players and the support they have here today.
I think as long as the Celtic-Hibs game remains 0-0, it would be probably until the whistle actually goes, because you know what football's like. You've seen teams score more than one goal in injury time, so I think unless they maybe see it a bit sooner if Hibs manage to take the lead, but there's a long way to go.
It's wrestled to the ground, and that's a free kick for Rangers. We did think that last year's drama couldn't be matched. If Celtic score a winner in the 90th minute, that'll do the job.
But you know, they just need to score. They don't. I mean, I'm sure they would rather have scored already, and it's a bit more comfortable for them. But they would not be caring, you know, about the drama. They'd just be caring that they won it. But it'd be fantastic for the league, as you say, right down. Because I think it was the 91st minute or something last
time,
year.
Yeah. Rangers have got this all tied up. Pierre Medag and Arnett looking to make it even sweeter. Oh, sour free kick. Doherty on and on. Not sure she would have kept it in play anyway, but the obstruction means that the whistle goes in Rangers' favour.
It was definitely a wee free kick. She just clipped her in the leg, and I didn't think he was going to give it actually, but it's a good position for Rangers, just like that goal Catherine Hill scored that get disallowed. It's a similar position to that.
opting for short this time. McLaughlin pulls the trigger, and off the base of the post it goes.
I'm wondering if you didn't get a hand in that there, did you?
Never looked like it from this angle, but the goal kick awarded. Through a crowd of bodies, hard to say. Scored in the cup final as well, Olivia McLaughlin against Thistle, so as previous this term. Harvey holds up. Medag. Arnott's take read by Lawton. Hill. From range. That rush of blood to the head yields no reward for Rangers.
Catherine Hill's got a strike on her. You see it there, a lot of power in it. But yeah, she obviously can't hit the target. But she confidence in herself and fancies it from there. But yeah, nowhere near.
Not enough to get back to her feet despite the grimace on her face. Back to Essena, very rare touch. The goalkeeper right at the end of the half. A half which ends with Rangers on the top of the table. Celtic unable to break through Hibs over at Celtic Park just yet. And that means, as it stands, Rangers are the champions of Scotland. They need to hope that Celtic continue to fail in their quest to get past the Hibs. They're keeping their end of the bargain here. At half-time, it's Rangers 3, Partick Thistle 0. Thank you.
Welcome back to Broadwoods. Rangers certainly making things interesting on the final day of the SWPL 1 season. 3-0 up against Partick Thistle at the start of the second half. Celtic 0-0 against Hibs at Celtic Park. Changes for both sides. Jane Ross is coming on for Rangers, as is Sarah Ewins. Little change in shape then. I think Kirsty McLean has been withdrawn. Kirsty Hewitt remains on the park. We did wonder if it was Carlton Hardy who would depart. Changes as well for Thistle. McAllister has come on. Doherty has come on. And Carla Boyce has come on as well. Just as the second half is about to get underway there, so a wry smile and a puff of the cheeks from Nicola Doherty. What a massive 45 minutes ahead for her and her teammates. Not necessarily here. I think they pretty much have it all wrapped up. It's more about what happens now in Glasgow. If Celtic can be denied by Hibs, Rangers will be champions for the second time. Here goes Doherty, cutting across Lawton. Donaldson cleans up. There's Ewins, who can just come back from an offside position. Cup final in the top six for Brian Graham this season. It's been memorable. They have really eviscerated last season's points total, 9 more. In fact, it really just speaks to the level Thistle are at the moment. They're struggling in the splits consistently against teams of a stronger standing, but against teams below them, as Ewins is snared offsides, they've only been beaten once against any team in the bottom six this season, Partick Thistle. That was Spartans back in the autumn. So, considerably better return this term for Brian Graham. He's just improving and improving this Thistle team. In fact, when Rangers went undefeated and won the league in 21-22, Thistle finished second bottom with 4 wins all season. So it's been an incredible turnaround across such a short space of time.
And I think that's it. It just shows the journey that they've been on, and so quickly as well, and how good a job he's done with them. As I said before, it's about the limited resources that Partick Thistle have got. They're competing with all the other Glasgow clubs, but they've still got a decent standard of player at that team. They're very organised. They know what each other's jobs are. So I think you have to be impressed with the job that Ryan Graham's done.
And the budget constraints as well. Another players that Thistle have been looking at in the past that we might try and offer a contract to and suddenly realise we can't pay you because it will swallow up about a quarter of our budget for the whole season, and that just puts them really at a disadvantage. So the work that Brian and his staff have been able to do with this team, and it's not just them, Hearts as well, they finished only just above Thistle 2 seasons ago, right at the wrong end of the table, third bottom. Now their Scottish Cup final, finished fourth.
And Hearts have massively invested in their women's team as well. And you see, when you give a team that platform and the staff and the players that platform, how much they can then grow, because Hearts have been impressive this season. They play good football, you know, they've beaten Rangers, they've drawn with Celtic.
It's going to be a free kick to Rangers right on the edge, and yellow card, I think that's Amy Bullock, who's in the book. As Chelsea Cornick gets back to her feet.
She can't really argue, you know, not that she is, but she needs to make the tackle. She's about to shoot, so I don't think there's anything wrong with the actual tackle she's made. You can clearly see she's trying to get the ball, but misses it. As a yellow card, free kick, right decision.
Lizzie Arnott made a mess of the last one.
She's been expelled from these conversations, so it's Mia McCauley who looks poised. Thistle Medag loitering as well. And not far away from Mia McCauley going for that glorious reverse into the keeper's top right.
It looked very close, didn't it? It looked as if it did not miss by much. She gets a great connection on it, up and over the wall. Yeah, it's just a bit too wide. I don't know if it just looks closer from this angle.
Some of the Thistle changes at half-time. That's Claire Docherty who came on for Shona Cowan. She's just come back from injury, Shona Cowan. And Claire Docherty, I think, took a knock recently as well. So 45 minutes each for them. That's the maximum that Cowan could put in today. And she's won that one fairly. Lawton showing interest, McAllister too. Ewens, has helped Rangers significantly in their quest for the title this season by giving them the lead against Thistle at the end of April as the game started to head into its embers. 1-1 at 85 before Ewens came off the bench to nod Joe Potter's side in front. Title win a couple of seasons ago stopped City's run of 15. It would have been 15 in a row had they won it. They then subsequently did last season in that incredible climax at Ibrox.
I think that shows you how much the league's changed and improved. Potentially going to have three different winners in three years.
Celtic need to do something about that. 0-0 against Hibs as we start to approach the hour. Rangers more than doing what's asked of them today. They have Partick Thistle at the length of a couple of arms.
I think the closer and closer it gets to the end of this half as well, it's going to be difficult to keep your full concentration on this game for Rangers, particularly the longer it stays 0-0.
McAllister trying to get away from Cornet, who's dispossessed. Taylor for Henderson. Donaldson is a mile offside.
She'll just give them a bit more energy, I think, trying to go forward. She likes to do that. She's direct. As you say, she just finds herself straying offside there.
McLaughlin grappling with Donaldson unfairly, says the referee.
I think she does well there to win that free kick. She comes in, she uses her body. She's got her arm across McLaughlin, who then gives the foul away, and they've got a good position here for this free kick. It's just if they can do anything with it.
Taylor in. Comfortable for Essen.
And the Rangers defence will be wanting that all day for Essen just to come out and gather that ball. Just takes so much pressure off, particularly when you trust your keeper behind you to come and just collect the ball.
A bit of sustained intent here for Thistle, the likes of which we haven't seen in the last hour.
I think it was positive changes though from Brian Graham. You know, he's obviously thought nothing to lose here, we're 3-0 down. And I think it is. It's very positive changes. And why not go for it? You don't have anything to lose at this point.
They have won 8 points against sides in the top half this season. They have beaten Hibs twice and drawn against them. And also taken a point, more impressively, against Rangers in a 0-0 draw.
But actually in that game, I think, you know, Rangers were lucky not to be beaten in that game. They did score. And in my opinion, there was nothing wrong with the goal. So I think they've held their own, as you said. Yeah, maybe not winning these games, but they're certainly collecting more points against the higher sides in the league.
McLaughlin forward for Rangers as Ross does well enough just to hold up. Hill, Doherty, Arnott breezing past Taylor, Ewins, and Ross just couldn't stretch far enough, quickly enough, accurately enough, and wide it goes for Rangers, who actually about 12 minutes into the second half see their first flurry forward of the second end in nothing.
It's great play again by Lizzie Arnott down the wideries. I think Mia McCauley and Lizzie Arnott have been key today to Rangers' performance and the goals that they've managed to get, but I think Lizzie Arnott will be wondering how that didn't end up in the back of the net with one of her teammates.
It down well into the path of Howitt. It has McCauley arriving. This is just where she wants it. McCauley, Faulkner in the way.
Starting to get a little heated actually the game, isn't it? There's been a few quite feisty tackles going in, but Mia McCauley again here. I'm actually surprised you didn't go on your right foot to shoot, and she chooses to come inside into bodies, and I think that's ultimately why she can't get the best shot away.
Has to judge the bounce. Can be awkward on these parks. Doherty. Ross. Had her own injury trouble to contend with. Hopefully now well in the past. 16 months out injured. Jane Ross before she made her return in December. Goal scoring return as well against Motherwell. She's managed to chip in here and there. Couple from double figures for the league anyway.
I think Jane Ross has been a key player for this squad. Just, you know, her experience.
She's looking to help shovel Rangers forward. Here it comes to McLaughlin! No stopping that. And certainly no stopping Rangers today.
persistent yet patient in the final third. And Olivia McLaughlin, and potentially our last home game for Rangers, thumps into the back of the net for four.
It's a brilliant finish, and actually Sarah Younes does really well to hold the ball up in the box and wait for the right moment to release it to McLaughlin, who's, you can't miss from there, can you? Fires it in. Great finish, and Rangers can do no more here.
Rangers fourth against Partick Thistle for the second time this season for Olivia McLaughlin. The last time it was in the League Cup final. Here comes Amy Anderson. And for Rangers there are a few changes as well. Lizzie Arnott is departing. Rogan Hay and Ailey Austin entering the fray.
I think Lizzie Arnott in particular has been excellent today for Rangers. She's had a great game. She's more than contributed to the performance that they've had today.
Interesting to see Brogan Hay on the left side of the midfield for Rangers. Certainly a right-footed player. I wonder if they are hoping to be able to cut in a little bit more. Colley. Past the hour mark at Celtic Park, still 0-0. Not just a league title on the line for Rangers. Remember, they have a Scottish Cup final to play next week against Hearts. There is maybe some even extra gold at the end of the rainbow if they can get this over the line today.
I'm sure they're all down there and maybe thinking at this point that it potentially could happen, but again, 60 minutes away, still a long time to go in that half. So they just need to keep going the way they're going here. You know, they'll be priding themselves and trying to get as many goals as they can.
Important interception from Doherty, who is now trying to stop Lawton. His cross made its way in. McLaughlin thumps clear. Hey, McAllister there. Cornets. Nicely done for Ross. Nicely done for McCauley. Breezes past Doherty. But that's also a breeze for Ava Easden.
The game's starting to open up a little bit more, I think. I think it's probably just down to tired legs, really. Partick Thistle have spent a lot of this game without the ball. And also they're trying to push up a little bit higher, which creates more space. But I think if that continues on, you probably find that Rangers will start to get more chances.
I wonder how easy or difficult Joe Potter is finding it right now not to constantly check on what's happening over in Celtic Park. Pretty sure she'll have someone in her ear whenever she wants.
I'm sure she'll definitely know what's happening, but I think the thing is, it's hard not to want to know what's happening, particularly at this point with Rangers winning and Celtic just currently drawing, so knowing that you've got one hand on it.
Austin clipped by Amy Anderson.
Boys, out.
Rangers had to win on the final day last season. They started with a better goal difference by one. In the end, beaten 1-0 by Glasgow City. Celtic were denied in the last minute. Incredible three-way tussle for the title. As McLaughlin plays it through for Ewins. That's a fair and timely tackle from Docherty.
That's great play, great intricate play between them there. I think the Docherty manages to get herself and her body across that. You think Sarah Ewins is going to pull the trigger, but she gets in, does enough to put her off.
Hey. Morton with a fistful of blue, and that's a Rangers free kick.
I understand it's frustration. I've been there myself. I've done it before myself, if I'm being honest, but it's something you really don't want to get a yellow card for, because you're still half an hour of this game to go, and then you're finding yourself having to play it.
It's Medag who has responsibility here. Again, Rangers not shy with the numbers they're sending forward. Past Austin. That's a Thistle ball.
Never really came to much at all. Probably not enough power on the cross that high for Austin.
For Brian Graham, nothing can detract, certainly today, nothing can detract from how impressive his side have been this season. If you want context, between the start of October and February, Thistle won 12 of their 15 games. As they go for one from range, and Carla Boyce almost stirring the pot slightly.
Yeah, I've played with Carla before. I've seen her do that on occasion in games, so she's going to take any opportunity that she can to shoot. She's obviously looked up, seen Essen well off her line, and she's got the capabilities to put it in the net from there.
Watton tries to keep it going. That's fizzed across, intercepted by Medag. Really hard not to be impressed by Emma Lawton at right back. Curious to see what the future holds for her, whether it's at Thistle next season or not.
I think they'll be desperate to keep her. I think she works really hard. She's up and down that line. She must be shattered after the game. But yeah, they absolutely will be wanting to keep her, but just as you say, there'll be bigger clubs maybe interested in her, and it's whether she decides that's what she wants to do with her future.
Well read by Cornett, who saw Jane Ross asking. That's us at 70 now at Celtic Park, 0-0. Rangers would owe a few favours to Hibs if they can stop Celtic today. McCauley, lesser seen in the second half actually. Maybe that change at half time with Docherty coming on has quelled her intent going forward on the right hand side.
I think Docherty has made a difference coming on at half time to try and nullify Mia McCauley. She's a great defender, Claire Docherty. I think in the last game against Partick at their home ground when they drew, I think she had a brilliant game. I thought she really stopped Rangers' threat. So I think, yeah, she's definitely made an improvement down that side for their defence.
Hay. Cannons off Taylor. That 0-0 Old Firm draw 3 games ago for Rangers and Celtic. Looking like it could be a bit of a difference maker. As Ewins picks up the slack clearance from Faulkner, Easton, with the help of a few colleagues, guarding the front post.
She just gets the luck of the ball. It's unlike Faulkner, right enough, not to get rid of it out of the box. She just makes a wee mistake there, giving it back to Ewins, but manages to push her wide enough that she can't get anything from the cross, and it's straight in Easton's hands.
Ailey Austin with the throw, still a teenager. Potentially part of a title winning team now after spending last season on loan at Hamilton. McLaughlin thinks that Ewins is onside. The assistant doesn't agree.
I think she just strayed offside, certainly looked like it, but it was the right ball, right idea, right run. It's just the timing of it all, isn't it?
Austin, the substitute to it. Will require a bit of TLC here.
She's been a great young player as well. You maybe not had quite as many minutes as the likes of Mia McCauley over the season, but I think when she's come on to games, you know, she was playing in that Old Firm game you were just talking about, and I thought she was excellent. You know, she plays with confidence. So certainly be hoping that she's not got any serious injury.
Rangers do have Martinez on the bench. We could slot in. They do have one change left. Four minutes gone at Celtic Park. I think we're officially in, keeping an eye on what's happening there every 20, 30 seconds. Now it's 15 minutes for Rangers.
It's definitely come to the crunch now, particularly for Celtic. As I said, Rangers, they've done their job here. Well, almost, and there's still 15 minutes to go, but it'd be difficult to see Partick Thistle coming back from that 4-0 down. But I think Celtic, you know, it's, can they get themselves over the line? As you were saying, they couldn't do it last year. And it's, can they change that around and get themselves over the line this year?
Quick check at the stats in the Celtic game. 3 shots on target with 3/4 of the game played for Celtic. It's not the barrage that I think stoppages. Nadam was burst for Thistle long ago. Rangers will look to just add a couple more for a bit of gloss. Yeah, their job here is done. It's now about what happens at Celtic Park. As it stands, Rangers are champions.
And I'm sure the players on the pitch, they will be thinking about it, but it certainly must be worse for the players sitting at the side, because it's all you'll be thinking about, as you'll say, checking to see what the score is, waiting to see what's going to happen.
Ben Adams coming on for Thistle. She's overcome an ankle injury to be involved in some part today. And Jodie McCleary replaces Kirsty Howitt.
Kirsty Howitt again, excellent today for Rangers. Done her job, started off the scoring, as you said, opened the dam for them. So, yeah, she'll be delighted with her performance, particularly if it goes Rangers' way.
Nida again. Breaks for McLaughlin, who was interested, there's no doubt about that. And Taylor will be relieved at that whistle. Was blown, she was up a blind alley. Lawton, the break of the ball, McLaughlin, her shadow, and nobody in Thistle colours had gambled. Wonderful play by Lawton, who has impressed today yet again.
She has. We've spoke about her all game because of how important she's been, but again, you know, 80th minute, she's still making runs right up into the corner of the pitch. And she gets a wee bit of fortune and it gets through Cornet's legs. But, you know, she probably deserves it, just given the way she's played. And, again, just can't find Boyce in the box.
McCleary, who's been given a few starts for Rangers recently. Off the bench for the final 5 minutes or so, maybe just more. As Boyce has played through, flag up again. They've certainly caused Rangers more problems after the changes at half-time.
I think they have. I think, as I said, you know, at that point, 3-0 down, I don't think you've got anything to lose. So I think it definitely was positive changes by Brian Graham. I think the substitutes have made a difference in the game. It's just, again, the final pass, isn't it? The final ball, the final run.
Bending off Slater. Comes to Cornet. McCleary. Away it goes from Lawton. Ross with the flick. Rangers moving at 5 miles an hour on the park now. I think Joe Potter's mind in the technical area moving at 100.
Definitely it will. And as I said, I think the players at this point will just be, what is there, 7 minutes to go or so potentially in the Celtic game. So they'll just be thinking about, are we going to have it taken away from us?
This time last year, City had yet to take the lead at Ibrox. And then subsequently Rangers scored and had it ruled out. Ewan's across, Ross! A split second
separates Rangers from a fifth.
It's a great play again by Younes. I think they two have done well, linked up well together since they've come on. But she gets the better of Slater here, and it's a wicked delivery, actually. It's just the pace. There's too much pace on it. That's why she can't get in the end. But a toe away from it.
Just had to try and adjust her stride to get to the end of it, Jane Ross. Sarah Younes has done well to play her way into more contention at Rangers. She's got a pecking order that sees probably three forwards ahead of her. But she's contributed when called upon, and she's played in the second half of the season probably more than one might have suspected, especially with Jane Ross coming back to fitness as well.
Yeah, I think so. I think it was maybe a slow start from her perspective when she first came to Rangers. But as you said, I think her form's definitely picked up and getting used a lot more this second half. I think, in my opinion, when teams sit really deep against Rangers, you know, Sarah Younes likes to space in behind, and I think she's more effective when she's got space to run into. And obviously when teams sit so deep, then that the space is no longer there. So I don't know if that's maybe contributed to why, you know, trying to find how she fit into the Rangers system.
Former Celtic player, Sarah Younes. Now, as the time ticks by, looking like she'll be part of the team celebrating at the end of proceedings today. Unless Celtic can find a winner against Hibs in the next 5 to 10 minutes. Ross on the chase. Cleary back for Hay. Ross exchanges with her. Younes doesn't take a chance this time. It's done and dusted for Rangers as far as they're concerned. Another goal would just be an extra exclamation mark. It all rests on what's happening about 10 miles down the road.
You just feel as if another goal is going to come for Rangers, but she's just across the front post, too far away. It's just too hard an angle to go onto it, but it does feel that another one's on the way.
The excitement is audibly starting to build and increase here within Broadwood. The sun's come out. The fans are finding their voice.
And I think that's the thing with Celtic, you know, notoriously in past games, they will just go for it. You know, they're not scared about just putting people up front and going route one. So are they going to be thinking about doing that at this point? You know, all they need is one goal.
Wonderful turn from Cornets. Doherty trying to drag her down. Rangers, I think, have been awarded, if not the corner, then a free kick initially. As the advantage, and the advantage was given, subsequently seen out, and it's a goal kick to Thistle. The yellow card goes to Doherty for the foul. Into injury time, Claire. It's starting to get to the, or I think we're in the now or never stage. For Celtic, anyway.
Yeah, I think so. And as I was just saying a second ago to you, Andy, I think, you know, they're not scared about just putting players up there and just going for it. So I would expect that that's exactly what they'll be doing right now, because it's all or nothing really, isn't it?
McCleary. And penalised on Anderson. The minutes have turned to seconds. Rangers have done everything they can, but they need Celtic to flounder, to continue to flounder. Up for Ross. Ewan's in the box. McCleary in. And Taylor away. Incredibly, in stoppage time for the second season in a row, the SWPL title will be decided by the finest of margins in the final seconds of the season. Celtic have taken the lead against Hibs in the 90th minute. And that goal, provided nothing else happens at Celtic Park, will deny Rangers the title.
It's just unbelievable at this point, and I doubt the players certainly on the pitch, the players at the sideline will know, but the players on the pitch I don't think will know at this point. They'll think that they've been doing enough, and I can imagine, you know, what a spectacle again for the league, but it's a horrible way to lose in the last minute of a game.
Amy Gallagher, of course, for Celtic, it had to be Amy Gallagher, who has given them the lead against her former club, and Rangers, for all the control and dominance they've had today, always knew it would rely on Celtic slipping up, but in the final seconds of the season they've kept their balance and their composure.
They have done, and you know, as it's a credit to Celtic, you know, they've had a new manager come in halfway through a season. They're trying to understand how she wants to play and what she expects from them. And, you know, the form arguably dipped a little when she first came in, but they've certainly pulled that back. I think they finished the season the strongest side. So I think for them, you need to give them credit. And I certainly think they will feel as if it's long overdue.
Joe Potter must be feeling her heart rate decrease slightly here. A few moments ago, she was just waiting on the final whistle in Glasgow's East End to confirm her side as the champions of Scotland. And deflation will wash over this Rangers side at full time here, unless Hibs can find an equaliser. It's been a canter at Broadwood for Rangers this afternoon. They've been in control from the first minute, but destiny was never in their hands. Here's Docherty. Hey. And it looks like for the third season running there will be a different champion of the top flight in Scotland.
I certainly think from the league's point of view, it's great. It's great for the game when you've got so many teams that can compete to maybe win that title. As you said, three different winners. So,
well, that's Rangers keeping their end of the bargain. They've demolished Thistle this afternoon. 4-0, a Howitt double. McLaughlin and Medag as well. But unless Hibs can do something in the final seconds at Celtic Park, it'll just be another win in isolation for Joe Potter's side. Just in case there's
another reason to expect the unexpected in the SWPL. We'll hang on.
And I think that's the thing now. It's going to be so tense for those players down there. Just waiting. You're just waiting and hoping that something Hibs can do you a favour.
Well, as the game entered its 90th minute, Rangers on the bench anyway will have known and be keeping, if not one, then both eyes on what was happening at Celtic Park. And instead of the full-time whistle here, it's the full-time whistle there that means everything for the outcome of Rangers league season. They still have a Scottish Cup final to play for in any case. But it now looks extremely unlikely that they will have a treble at the end of the campaign. The wait is not the excited, palpable one that it might have been just more than 5 minutes ago. There are no scenes of the Rangers team gathered around a screen to watch Hibs see out a 0-0 draw at Celtic Park.
I think that would be the thing that would be difficult for the Rangers squad if it is so late in the game that they then lose what they felt as if was almost their title.
And Rangers, if they don't know now, will know in the next couple of seconds. But that's it. Celtic, by the skin of their teeth, have won the SWPL one in the final minutes of the season. And Rangers must take an applause of encouragement, but also sympathy. 5 minutes ago, it looked like they were going to win the league. Denied again in stoppage time. On the final day of the season, two seasons in a row for Rangers after 12 months of dominance. And as the curtain comes down on SWPL one season, once again Rangers are left disappointed on the final day. They were in complete control from the start here. Howitt, Medag, McLaughlin and Howitt again. But that control on the park could never and would never translate to how much they had on the league table. They always had to rely on Hibs to stop Celtic. And though they almost did, just not enough. And SWPL1 has another final day, D-Day drama for the history books, Claire.
It's been fantastic for the game. I think it's exactly what you want from a league. You know, I'm sure Rangers, the manager, the staff, the players will all be disappointed because, as you said, it was a lot of dominance in that league. I think there's points in this season they'll look back on where they've probably thrown it away because they had such a, I think it was a 7-point lead at one point. So really, you know, credit has to go to Celtic to change their season around, claw that back. They could have easily given up, but you know, they turned a corner and I think they finished this season the strongest team and probably deserve the title.
Well, that draw against Hearts and amongst all those split fixtures might be the one that Rangers look back on, sorry, the defeat against Hearts might be the one that Rangers look back on and think that is where we have let the title slip. Couple of games against Celtic in there as well which have ultimately helped make the difference. A draw in the Old Firm derby and then right at the start of the split as well, a 2-1 defeat. And Rangers, for all their efforts, ultimately come up short again.
But then I think when the only thing is through a season, you know, it's highly unlikely you're going to get through season after season where you're unbeaten. So although you will look back in those games, and I do think those games were important, I think it's a fact coming up towards the crunch part of the season, the last few months, they've probably not been clinical enough. So that's why the goal difference has been out of hand. If it's only a few goals, it's manageable at that point. So I think, you know, there's different aspects to this season that they will look back on and I think will be disappointed. But, you know, they've still got a cup and they've got a cup final next week. So it's by no means not a successful season for them.
For Thistle, 12 defeats in their last 13 games of the season. A tough split for them. Their title was getting into that top six once again, blowing last season's points total out the water, 9 more points. But it was about Rangers and Celtic today. And Celtic, in the final seconds, have snatched the title away from Rangers, just like Glasgow City did last season. And a long old season ends with no league title for Rangers. As Claire says, they have the League Cup in the cabinet, they have the Scottish Cup to play for. And they'll be back next Sunday to contest that with Hearts. But today, stoppage time. Once again, their nemesis. This time not on their patch, but at Celtic. Where Amy Gallagher scored in the final seconds of the season to secure the title for Elena Sadiku's side. It finishes with Celtic top, Rangers second. And here at Broadwood, Rangers 4, Partick Thistle 0.